composition part and composition part is only of 40 marks. Okay. So here you go, first class. So grammar part, what you have? Question number 5 it starts. Grammar starts with question number 5. In A, what we have? 5A, we have verbs. Okay? 5B, we have joining. I see we have phrasal verbs. And 5D, do as
by the
okay. Now this dual priority, it seems one topic. It seems only four topics we have. But in fact, we have plenty of topics. For verbs, what do you have to go through? We have to go through transitive and you will get a syllabus. In syllabus, keep it in mind, it will not be like other classes. That first unit you will have noun, pronoun, adjective, verb. Will not get like this. You will have full-fledged question, ICC pattern. Clear? Specified question I will send you in Deno. Last year's question or previous year question I will send you in Deno. Okay? Okay. Transitive, intransitive, finite and non-finite, kindly keep writing with me. Okay? Number two, number three, we have this one, V1, V2 and V3 format you have to learn, okay, auxiliaries, who is the monitor of the class, you should have reached the board, okay. Today later, you should clean it properly. Don't you have any cloth piece in the class? You have to wait that and you have to clean that. Monitor must give the class later, you sit down. Okay. Auxiliaries. Next, one is going to be, after auxiliaries what do you have? Better modals. So basically it seems only part. But when you peep inside, look inside, this is the reality. Okay, if we go to joining part, last year when I was teaching online, I gave you much importance to conjunction part. I always talk about conjunction. Conjunction, believe me, it is the most important part of it. So, joining is related for conjunction. Phrasal verbs, this is quite different than others. In other cases, you need to use your mind to answer this one, but this one you have to memorize fully. Phrasal verbs. Memorize means you have to practice. Since class 6 used to have a chapter, group verb or phrasal verb, some 20-30 example used to be there. Correct or not? You have to write an exam. So these things will be here. Now, you don't have a specified number of phrasal verb here. In book, this book, Joseph, this red color book, you call it Joseph. This book contains some 300 phrasal verbs. Okay. But no need to memorize. When you practice, it will become easier. One thing be sure, give importance to your language. Literature will come automatically. And what I am saying, not to motivate you, not neither to inspire you, this is the fact. Since last 7-8 years I am teaching and this is what I understood. If you are good at language, literature will be very good. Because in this year, And pain also, you should not be writing any answer in literature that is memorized. You will be writing your own answer. Clear? You will not memorize any answer and all. Clear? You have to understand, write your own. And you will get full marks for that. But if you memorize and write, it will be very methodic. Now, Faisal Haq is trying, now who has directed? Keep some gap between you. That will look nice and be nice. Okay. First one, guided to indirect. I'm writing in short. Today we'll go home and get the syllabus. Okay. We'll get the syllabus today. But in syllabus, if I write all these things, it will be something which is syllabus only. For class 10 and 9. Direct and indirect. Then, obviously, active, passive. Next, conditionals. Done. Transformation of sentences. Transformation of sentences. Let me come here. First you have written this for?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, since the two teachers will be teaching you this one now. The two teachers. Okay. So what will happen? Can we take different terms? Clear? If copy should not be then. For me, if you won't copy, I won't copy. This two copy can be your old copy. If you have new copy, use that. If you don't have, then it's old one also. But there should be separate copies. One copy for the qualification part and one copy for the comprehension and grammar part. Okay. And no need to make separate homework copy for my subject. That copy only you submit as homework copy. And only you will be submitting that one, no? You will be writing in the total English book. You know, I am not what I mean. So when you will get that time, you will write some other things. Okay, we'll have to. Next, transformation of sentences done. Next one is going to be degree of comparison. Degree of comparison. Little. Next. Interchange. Interchange of what? Noun to adjective. Noun to adjective or adjective to noun, same as verb. Noun to verb. Or verb to noun. Just like this one. His story did not amuse me. Amuse is not here. Are you asking use amusement instead of amuse? What did you write? This is coming in one direction. What you said? This story did not give you amusement. Or his story was devoid of amusement. So here I am converting noun into verb or verb into noun. So it sounds dual directed, but that is beyond that one. Actually, all the chapters you study from class 5 to class 3. This is a fact. Next, interchange of noun, adjective and verb. Next, that is going to be here. write down. Affirmative to, affirmative means you know, means positive. Affirmative to negative, or maybe what? Interrogative or interrogative or what next? Exclamation. Okay. Shall I come here? Next, error correction. Conjunction related topics. Conjunction related topics. So this thing is here. Till now, what I have given is 25% or 20% of the total. But this one is enough. Is the writing all done? Okay. So tell me, today's strategy is very complete. Now, keep it in mind, nothing is going to be same this year. Okay, question will be up like this. Look at here. This is not coming over. Now, it will be like this. I said to him, come on, invite me, come on. When are you free? One specimen I am giving. Direct to indirect question. This will be not form, it will come in dual directed past. So it will be given like this. Begin with he. Begin with he. Right, sir. Someone write down the sentence. Begin with he. I won't come or anyone absent today? Anyone absent today? Huh? Who? Has anyone written? Question is not that you have to give answer. Question is that it is that easy like previous years. No, Now look, basically if I convert this one, it will be like what? It is interrogative sentence. I said to him, no. It will be I asked him. Interrogative sentence, correct? Answer should be what? I asked him. When? Who's the you here? That fellow, now? He. When he was? This is the proper answer. But this answer is asked here. Is it asked? No, no. You have to begin with he. It is written I asked him. It should be what? He was asked by me when? So in the same sentence, you will have direct, indirect, as well as active. Got it? Same sentence, you will have direct, indirect, as well as active. Write down, he was asked by me. Then what is written there? When? He was? Yeah, topic is not heard. Topic is written confusing. Keep it in mind, topic will not be hard. What you have studied through the classes, that won't only be asked. But it will be little twisted or little confused. That is why first day told you have to be